y'all. How you doing today? This is Todd. Jared's behind the camera. We're starting another hog trap back here, and I'm going to show you around kind of what we got. I needed to build a big hog trap. Our small hog trap, which is right here on the side, is too small. They won't come in that small door. We've got a herd of about 30 that's hanging around, and we're starting to feed in here. We got a big gap cutting in this fence right here for the hogs to come in. There's a big hole right here from this corner to this post is a hole. Okay, right now we're pouring the corn in here so we can get everything to start coming in here, you know, get the hogs to start getting used to it. I'm gonna put a gate right here, which is gonna be 5 foot tall and 8 foot wide. So that means it's gonna be sticking up in the air a little over 10 foot. So it's gonna be a real big door coming in here. I'm building it all out of iron. It's gonna be wire. It's real massive. I'm just started building it this morning. But guys, what the problem is, that small door, they see it and they see the door on top, they won't come in. They get, some of them are just too smart for it. They just won't come in to small doors. So we're gonna build a big one with a big trap. Maybe we can start catching some more hogs. I'll show y'all around in here and see what's going on. All right, what this is right here, that is an old, it was made for calves, to squeeze calves in the chute. It's no more good, it's obsolete. Well, it was in the back. My daddy used to use it years ago. But I'm using it for the iron, for the weight. My fence is on the back side. Also, the hogs cannot just come and jump over the fence. They'll hit this, they can't get over the top of this. I'm gonna come from the end of this and go up and around. It's gonna be a high fence. I gotta have some place for the deer to get out. Right here, I got the hog trap. This is the Old Faithful hog trap. It's gonna be in this pen. I'm not using that door for anything except for if we catch a sow. I'm gonna put a sow in there, lock her up in there, feed and water her to kind of entice them to come in. The sow helps them come in when you do that. But I'm gonna go with a high fence in the back and all the way around. The only place that's not gonna be high is on this side right here where my deer can get out. If something happens, they get trapped in here. They shouldn't knock the trigger loose, but sometimes they do. And it's 8 foot fence behind you, so they can't get out. I gotta have a place for the deer to get out. But guys, we're fixing to go work on the door. When I get the door done, I'll show y'all the door and I'll show you the setup and when we set the door up and how the trigger system is gonna work. All right, y'all, we're back at the house. We fed the cows, fed the hogs. We just went over there and dropped off a few T-posts at the trap. That trap is 20 foot wide and 32 foot long. Now I'm back at the shop over here. I'm gonna start making working on the door, trying to finish it out. I got a guy that's bringing me some of the wire for the panels on the door. I want the 2x3, I guess it's 2x3. It's what they call a horse panel. It's 16 foot long and 5 foot tall. It's a little bit stronger, a little bit smaller squares on it. That's what I'm gonna be putting on the front of that door. But when I get the door done, I'll show y'all that. But guys, that's all I got for today.
Let me ask you something. All right, we had the little trap to catch the hogs. I understand that. You said the door was too small. We're gonna catch the big hogs that's coming in. So.
Not really just the big hogs, the smarter hogs.
Okay, but
they feel like they're being in traps.
How big did you say that pen was that you just got built back
20
there?
20 by 32.
20 by 32. Why in the world do you need a 20 by 32 pen?
Because they feel safe when they come in there. They're not as scared as a small trap. They don't feel entrapped. It's bigger. They feel safer to come in.
So the door that you're putting on there is going to be like the regular drop door.
It's going to be what they call a guillotine door. Very big.
That might be Buddy with
the
wire.
I hear the wire coming.
Well, guys, we're going to go ahead and close it out. We'll bring you back when he's working on that gate and when he goes to hook everything up out there. We'll show you. I'm sorry we didn't film him building it, but I was out of commission for the last 2 days. But we'll be back. Thank y'all and God bless.
Bye-bye.